Hey, hello everyone, and praise the name of the Lord. This is Lever Simon Mwangi coming to you from Nairobi, Kenya, in Africa, and I bless God for his goodness and his faithfulness. You know, over the years, as I've been serving God for over 20 years now, one thing that I've discovered and one thing that I love that the Lord has given us is our ability to call upon him in prayer. Prayer is one of the best things that the Lord ever gave us. Because sometimes I ask myself, what happens when you are faced with a situation and you do not know what to do? If we were not given the privilege to pray and you are faced with situations, what will we do? We will be so miserable, we will be so hopeless. You know, our lives will be, you know, so frustrating, but we bless God for the opportunity to pray. Prayer is one of the most important things that the Lord has given to us as his children. And especially in such times when we are facing such difficult times because of the crisis in the world, you know, prayer is always our best option. It is always an only option. You know, the Bible says in James Chapter 5, one of my favorite verses or scriptures about prayer. The Bible says in verse 13, James chapter 5, verse 13, the Bible says, is anyone in distress? Other versions say, is anyone discouraged? Is anyone facing hard times? Is anyone in need? What should he do? The Bible says, let him pray. Wow, praise God. Let him pray. That tells us that we have an option. We always have a place to land. We have a refuge. Anyone in distress, anyone discouraged, anyone facing hard times, anyone in need, let him pray. And we bless God for giving us the ability and the privilege to come to him through prayer. And I just want to encourage each and every one of you that prayer is a resource that we can never exhaust. God has given us this resource to utilize. Not only in hard times, not only when we are going through crisis, but prayer is a daily thing, is a day-to-day activity, is a day-to-day privilege that the Lord has given us, our ability to speak to him. I like what the Bible says in verse 4, anyone among you sick? You know what that is telling us? Maybe you may not be in a position where you can pray for yourself. At times you find yourself in a situation that you try to pray and it's so difficult to pray. So the Bible says, anyone sick? Maybe you cannot pray for yourself. That still gives you an opportunity to utilize prayer as a solution. The Bible says, let him call the elders of the church and let him pray over him, anointing him with oil. And the prayer of faith shall save the sick. For the fervent prayer of a righteous man availeth much and is effective. So even when you don't have the ability to pray, the Bible tells us, call someone to pray with you. That shows us the need of us coming together as the body of Christ to pray for one another. It shows us the need of corporate prayers. So the Bible does not only introduce us to personal prayers, but also in corporate prayers where we come together as the body of Christ, like the way we are in this forum, to pray for one another, to pray for the nations of the world, to pray for the situations that we face, to pray for our families, to pray for, you know, every matter in our lives. The power of corporate prayer. And, I also like what the Bible says in verse 17 and verse 18. It shows us that, you know, when you pray, it's not an exercise in futility. It is something that works. It's a resource that brings in results. Verse 17, the Bible says, for Elias was a man like us with like passions, like each one of us, he could get discouraged, he could be feeling down, he could be feeling frustrated, he could be feeling helpless. But the Bible says, yet he prayed. Hallelujah. Elijah was a man like us, yet he prayed. And he prayed. The Bible says, and Elijah prayed. He was a man like us, yet he prayed that it may not rain for 3.5 years. And it did not rain. Then he prayed again and rain came. That shows us that prayer works. Prayer works. Prayer works. Prayer works. Hallelujah. That's why the Bible is giving an example of Elias, that he was a man like us and he prayed and his prayers brought in results. So brethren, in a time that we call upon God, he may delay in answering us. It may take a while at times, but that does not mean that prayer does not work. You know, when I was young in ministry of about 20 years ago, I would pray and I would wait for results, instant results, and I would think maybe God did not hear me, maybe I was not worthy enough. But I've come to realize that the greatness of faith is not how quick or how fast you get your answers, but the greatness of faith, like Abraham, is how long you're willing to wait on God to answer your prayer without wavering and without unbelief. And I've seen prayers that I prayed 20 years ago as I began ministry, God answering them now. Why? Because prayer works. And I just want to encourage someone today that every prayer that we are praying, individually and corporately, I want you to know that prayer works and God answers prayer. Finally, the Bible says in Jonah chapter 2, verse 1 and 2, you know, it's an account of Jonah inside the belly of the fish. The Bible says, and Jonah prayed unto the Lord out of the belly of the fish. And verse 2, he says, and I said, I cried by the reason of my affliction unto the Lord, and he heard me out of the belly of the fish. Out of hell I cried, and he heard my voice. Wow. What a wonderful, wonderful encouragement for us to pray and to continue praying. The Bible says that Jonah prayed inside the belly of a fish. You know, Jonah was inside the belly of a fish because of his own mistakes, because of his own disobedience. But guess what? When he prayed in humility, God heard him. The Bible says, he says in verse 2 that I cried for the reason of my affliction unto the Lord, and he heard me out of the belly of hell. I cried, and the Lord heard my voice. I just want to encourage each one of us, even all of us in this forum, I want you to know that every prayer we are praying, God hears. And it's a wonderful resource that God has given us. So let's continue praying. Let's continue trusting in God. Let's continue hoping in God. And I know God will continually hear us when we pray. It's not an exercise in futility. God hears us, and he also answers our prayers. I pray that the Lord may bless you, and the Lord may enlarge you, and everything that the Lord intends to, he purposes to do in your life, or has purpose to do in your life, shall not be cut off, or shall not be cut short, but everything shall be fulfilled to every single detail, to the glory of God the Father. May the Lord bless you, and may the Lord do you good. In Jesus' mighty name. Again, this is Reverend Simon Mwangi, coming to you from Nairobi, Kenya, in Africa. God bless you. God bless Apostle Brooks, and God bless every servant of God in this platform. And let's continue doing what God has called us to do. Shalom, peace, and God be with you. Thank you. For Elias was a man like us, with like passions, like each one of us. He could get discouraged. He could be feeling down. He could be feeling frustrated. He could be feeling helpless. But the Bible says, yet he prayed. Hallelujah. Elijah was a man like us, yet he prayed. You know what this verse is showing us? That prayer is not an exercise in futility. When we pray, we have a God who hears, and we have a God who answers prayers. The Bible says,